King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Let's begin to thank Him for another opportunity in His presence. Let's open our mouth and begin to worship Him. It's worthy to be praised. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You are God from beginning to the end. There's no place home as you were. You are God all by yourself. You are God. You are God from beginning to the end. There's no place for argument. You are God all by yourself. You are God, a God from beginning to the end. There's no place for argument. You are God, God by yourself. Let's open our mouth and appreciate Him. Thank Him for another new month in 2020. Open your mouth and worship Him. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Open your mouth and worship Him. Father, we thank you for another day in your presence. We thank you for the blessing you have programmed for us today. Lord, we worship you. Lord, we worship you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for guiding us through the hours of the night. Open your mouth and worship him. Open your mouth and appreciate him. Open your mouth and worship him. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. The blood of Jesus wash me clean this morning. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. Blood of Jesus, wash me clean this morning. Wash me clean this morning. Say. Blood of Jesus, wash us clean this morning. Wash us clean this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, wash us clean this morning. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Lift your right hand to the heavens. Say, we have power in the heavens. And you shall be the Lord. And I'm going to get our services this morning. We have power. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and say, we take power in the heavens. I'm fighting against our sanity this morning. You are a failure. Die. Open your mouth and say, in the name of Jesus, die. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Open your mouth and pray. You have put over our services this morning. You hear the word of the Lord. Open my back. We are living God. Man, the best of them in our service in this morning.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Thank you. We are still singing as we bring out our entertainment group and go to the number 44. In number 44. Who worship the King of glory as above and gratefully sing His wonderful Lord, our shield and defender, the nations of days, pavilion in splendor and guided with praise. In 44. Everybody together, let us pray. over 1,060. That shall be part of blessing, which is the promise of God. There shall be children refreshed, sent from the Savior of hope. Part of blessing, part of blessing we need. Let us trust how God has promised, but for the stars we bring.
Thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we worship. Now welcome to this beautiful morning service. It is where we talk to Jesus today. I will pray for us. Let me pray that I will talk to you later. The title of this morning is to pray with you in the mighty name of Jesus and you can be prepared to Jesus. It is time to start the scripture. Let us pray. Our glorious God, thank you for this. We thank you because you always pray for us. We bless your holy name, for this is another month. Glorious month for us. As we can dance with the mighty name of Jesus. As we have started this month in peace, and that it is to be peaceful with us in Jesus' name. We cover the place with the blood of Jesus. And let the Holy teach us from heaven above this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. In this world we have in Jesus' name. With Jesus, and in his name we pray. Let somebody say loud amen. Now we started the preaching last Sunday, and the passage is a highway of holiness, walking on the street and narrow way, and highway of holiness, a way that leads to holiness, and walking on the street and narrow way. When we say street, what do we mean by faith? Is it by stretching our faith or by making it great? That's what we mean. What we are talking about is, but we remember our prayers. We remember what he was. And when Jesus Christ asked him to come, he started to share it. Then he wants to be, he wants to walk with faith life. Wow. And he has to remove all those things. And that is, he will remove all those things that will cause problems from his movement and make his way to it. Steady with all this unnecessary weight, the weight of and the other weight. That's the only way we can come and walk with faith and narrow it. This morning we will continue and we are going to look at understanding the faith and the narrow way. The first one, and now let us look at the memory verse. And the Bible says, Matthew 7, verse 16, enter ye this great gate. For wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many thereby which go in thereafter. Matthew 7, verse 16. And he's asking us to enter at the great gate. And the other gate is very wide. You can carry a lot of weight to enter. Someone that is taking drugs can enter. A doctor can enter. For the teacher can carry it and enter. Anyone that needs to know that can be sickness can enter it. For people that they cannot pass that door, they can see that way and see that way. Do well that way, without any door. It can contain anything, but the great way that God is accurate cannot contain all the rubbish. We have to do away with rubbish. And I pray that every rubbish in our life, the Holy Ghost fire will rub it here in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us look at the understanding of faith and narrow it. It is the way to find yourself true faith. In Jesus Christ, John chapter 14, verse 6 and 6. Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but time, with the fellowship of Christ, and we can't. This prophecy is the way to salvation. What is salvation? Salvation is deliverance for us. No man can deliver anything. How self-pilot a person can be, how self-disciplined a person can be. Yes, you know, a lot of people that we think that are very, 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 very difficult. But when you look at your other standard, they because of what? The other one, they do it perfect. So it is only when you talk to the first sometimes you talk to some people that are very nice, because people are very nice, or because you don't do this one you talk before, you do that, you do that. You do not come to Jesus Christ. All those who want, they are feeling like so it is only through the church, and that's why the church has the same difference. I am the way, the truth, and the living. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. So it's like the Lord. You are still praying. You need to pray for your and for all the world, your siblings, your wife, your children, and let it come unto you. Don't think they're not like people on the left. Don't think they are. It is only through you that we can get to God. So, until we come to Christmas, on His death, we can follow, we can start moving in that particular way and narrow way. It is the way of truth. It is the only way of truth. That Psalm 119, verse 2. It is the way of the commandment. That is the way of the commandments of Almighty God. What He says to do, we are ready to do. And if we do not come to the first class, we do not accept the first class, you cannot know what God wants you to do. Anyone that is born again cannot have Holy Spirit. Anyone that does not have Holy Spirit, even when you read Bible, you just read it like you used to. You cannot get it from that. And even when you become born again, we still need to read our Bible, we still need to listen to the Word of God. And that's why we are supposed to be here at the right time to listen to the Word of God. Because if you don't read the Word of God, and you know His commandments, and His words, and not only, please, I follow His commandments. And if you don't read the book, if you don't read the Bible, which is our manner, how can you know His commandments, brethren, if you are not yet, if you are not yet speaking, and after reading your Bible, you don't have. It is the way of denying yourself to follow Christ. Matthew, I just talking about it. Matthew chapter 16, you want to read verse 13. But let's say to this example. If any man is not after me, let him deny himself and take off his cross and follow him. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it, and whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it. Last Sunday here, our father in law was 8 years, my father in law was 15. And see, if you are going to pass it, it will cost you something. What does it cost? What's happening? What does having God cost you? This case is telling us that it is the way of denying yourself. You deny yourself seed to be healed. You deny yourself from creating. And it was told by those others, you come to church and you follow your friend to be a father. No, that was just go that way. You are going to deny yourself of all those things. You are going to deny yourself of all those things. You cannot be a child of God and be working for yourself in the process. It's not possible. You are going to deny yourself for things. You are going to deny a lot of people that are not doing 20 to do it. If you are doing it, you are doing it. Amen. Of course, we cannot deny ourselves that it's just we cannot work on by 12. We cannot do it. We cannot do it. But you have to deny yourself. That's what is required to walk in the faith and widely, narrowly, or fully. It is the way to eternal life, for a true life. This is life that is going to end one created you as a child. As a child, that's how you say it. When God is going to love you, He's going to come to an end. And it is fast. So I find a lot of so he was talking about something like that. Last time he was yesterday, what he was talking about, he believed that he couldn't be come to pass. Not only that, you don't pray to God to enter into this world one day. You believe that you are not talking about this life. This other life is two places. So, the narrow aspect will lead you to keep on life with God. The other one that is God, you can do anything you like. You can do anything you like. You can do it anything you like. is also applied unto us. We need to testify by the people. How that I testify myself is by denying the death. All those things that your body just wants to do. You want to fight your body. And if by that, when you go to the other, you are supposed to testify your faith as the body of Christ to tell them that you are not good. I praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah. We are clapping for Jesus down everywhere.
My name is Sister Bola. I'm here to testify to the goodness of God for its mercy over my house, over my home. This testimony concerns my son. After coming back from youth service club in July, he was looking for a job up and down. He wrote many applications, but he never replied. But to God be the glory, there was a company that he wrote an application to a nearby day. In second week in December, they now called him to come and start work. I give God all the glory for his mercy over him. His name be praised forever in the name of Jesus.
Amen. That's asking for Jesus to have very well. We bless the name of the Lord for the testimony that you have received. We call that the testifier and the testimony of the Lord of Jesus. Let us stand up and pray like this.
Blessings that money cannot buy. And blessings that money can buy. It is not available. Manifest my life. Let me see the way to us. Blessings that money cannot buy. And blessings that money can buy. It is not available. Manifest my life. In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Then all Israel gathered themselves to David unto Israel, saying, Behold, we are thy bone and thy flesh. And moreover, in time past, even when Saul was king, thou wast he that led us out and brought us in Israel. And the Lord thy God said unto thee, Thou shalt feed my people Israel. Thou shalt be ruler over my people Israel. Verse 3. Therefore came all the elders of Israel to the king to Israel. And David made a covenant with them in Israel before the Lord. And they anointed David king over Israel, according to the word of the Lord by Samuel. And David and all Israel went to Jerusalem, which is Jebus, near the Jebusites were. The inhabitants of the land. And the inhabitants of Jebus said to David, Thou shalt not come either. Nevertheless, David took the castle of Zion, which is the city of David. Verse 6. And David said, Whosoever smiteth the Jebusite, thought shall be true, and acting. For Joab the son of Zeruiah went forth up. And was killed. And David dwelt in the castle. Therefore, they called it the city of David. And he built the city round about, even from Milo round about. And Joab repaired the rest of the city. Verse 9, which is the last of the Bible. So David was greater and greater, for the Lord of hosts was in them. Amen. May the Lord bless the reading of His word in our hearts and in Jesus' name. Let us close our eyes and pray like this. anointing for discretion, anointing to fulfill God's purpose, fall upon my life now. In the name of Jesus, anointing for distinction, anointing to fulfill God's purpose, fall upon my life now. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we are praying. Send to the prayers to your offering. Pray for the talking. Talk to your offering. Ask the Lord whatever He wants Him to do for you in this first Sunday of the new month. Connect with Him. In Jesus' name we pray. As we have declared it, it is perfect. We have asked God, we have answered our prayers, in this moment, in Jesus' name. Let's open our eyes and get the prayers to suffer and get back to the moment. I'm going to go to the next one.
I'm going to go to the next slide. Shout it loud, hallelujah! Stand up on your feet and shout it loud, hallelujah! Lift up your hands as we shout this one to the King of Kings and to the Lord of Lords, the God who has never failed.
So we are the Lord God of God.
This month will be a great month for you and your family. We will go from glory to glory. So we are reach you. I will pray for you.
I hope you are praying for the best. Just move right now and pray for the best.
The world will be.
And you will not be able to bless
you. You know.
Good God. Our God wants to overall. Let's continue to move on to the
Let us sit down to pray this one. One of the areas of target of the enemy is the staff. If you have staff, the enemy will not. They will give it a try. I wanted to say this prayer loud and clear, say it myself.
Say it very well. Say it very well.
You are not being kept by the enemy.
I will not be kept by the enemy. Lord, I want to capture by the enemy. Master, I want to capture by the enemy.
Every
every person that is very represented, but has been represented in this service today, in their marriage, where they lost the business.
heavenly Father. Father, let your name be glorified. Father, let your name be glorified. And let every devil be healed. Glorify your spirit. Thank you, heavenly Father. Thank you, heavenly Father. Thank you, heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Somebody said, the Lord is in us. The Lord will surprise you this year. You will see surprises from God. God will balance your blessing this year. And I decree by the decree of God. Of blessings was not a miracle. What can you do? Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Lord, amen. The Father, amen. Somebody very close to you and prophesy this prayer to the person. Pray to the person. Power that says prayer will not work for you this year. You have died violently. Say any power that says prayer will not solve your problem this year. You have died violently. Say a loud amen to that prayer. This is the time of God bless you.
Amen.
Morning, we continue from where we stop. The fear of God. Last week, we began to look at, we began to push forward in the light of in what word of the year has declared by our God and the Lord, which says that. This year is the year of what? Spiritual revival. Glory. I'm going to continue from where we start. We start at Tokai Glory. You must fear God. Then we began to look at several verses of the Bible, which we are not going to go back to. However, to continue this morning, I want you to look at 2 Corinthians chapter 7. First, continuing in the same line where we have always looked at. I want to continue from the same place. This is the long way to view. Whatever you are doing for the living, the Lord will invite them in Jesus' name. 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1 says, having therefore this promise, dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all holiness of the flesh and speak perfecting holiness. How? There is no way that a believer can live without the fear of God. The fear of God is the empty form of our life, the fear of God. How would people be able to judge you? How would they be able to assess your Christian life? People will assess your Christian life by the glory, the way you project God, the way you treat people. It's not something that Allah is teaching. It's not about what is coming. It is in the home to the Jew. Because God, when people look at us in this lesson, they can't come from Israel.
one's breath. Now, that is
we said on his friends is in his eyes.
I'm going to give you some thoughts that the level is in the pandemic. But as we go, as the war in the past, we saw that before that thing we mentioned, you know, go out and care for these people. He's fully already dedicated to us. What's not done that is done that not from doing our work. Now, what is this work was to present to Daniel and his friend. That was a hard time. I don't mean to embarrass you because I will be able to do this kind of thing.
To be holy.
And drop out.
we are going to be commanded for every them. Pray, oh God,
those who fear him. Those who fear God, they are set to reach a person. When you fear God, God is close to you. God will be glad with you. And to say that the measure of your fear of God is also the measure of the way you run from Satan. Because Satan has the capacity to waste any glorious victory. Satan is an identity card. And everyone who carries that identity card becomes a enemy of God. Satan has a way of enticing onto the soul of the person. He has the person into a life of I regret.
To find the trust, is that not? You're going to ask me I'm not going to be able to do it.
all the number of what? See the number of that we know what? All of that is blessed. You see that time left off? Time for? Oh no, just the what? What is this? Just for an hour. Amen. Amen. Don't go for what? It is not. I'm not telling you.
This morning, while we are praying, we are in this service. You have not given your life to Jesus. You have not known Jesus. You want Jesus to come into your life. You want to start all over again. Wherever you are. If you want to say that, I'm born. Let every weakness be a part of the let the Lord send them message. The judgment that is waiting them, let the judgment be removed. Give them another chance. Give them another opportunity. Particularly, anyone who is powerful, who is ready to serve God, oh God, show them mercy. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Jesus, my dear, we will pray. Let there be nobody who is in this study. Who will lead the study and continue the Lord with. Make your way right before the Lord. If you are in this study and you ask somebody, you have made up your mind not to forgive that person. Please do so. And it's to forgive the person. Please. Forgive the person. Forgive the person. Make people to know that you have chosen for irrespective of what is that now done to you. Forgive the person. Let the person go. Because today we want to let him go. Forgive the person. Let your son. Our lives is what we're supposed to be. And we're not to do with God. There is nothing God cannot do for us. The Bible says it's the way that we not doing with God. The things we will make it happen. We are missing things. If your way is fixed with God, God knows how to do it. Take a position. Don't do it.